May God bless you. You all can see me, is it? Or should I stand up? Today is a great day, today is very great day. I have said about it, it's still part of it. The first day of this 9th in this year, we'll start the manifestation of the new age. Of course, the new age has come long time back, but the manifestation is not so soft that much. It will start. But I find that attitude of human beings towards any divine working is getting strange. It has been very strange. If it was not, they never recognized Swami, they never recognized Rama, they never recognized Krishna. In the same way, they never recognized also Satyoga, this new age. When these people went, nobody bothered. Those who bothered were only bothered as to see how they kill or torture. Nobody could see through their sincerity, through their life, their power, that there is something great in incarnation, and we must make the effort. The reason is, man has his own ways of judging others. For example, a man goes to a god. And first he will find out who has made this god. Who is the one who has planned it? Then he find out who is the person who has been the god. Then he finds out from where the water is coming. Then he starts counting the trees. Then he starts counting the fruits. Then he starts counting the roots. I mean, also the fine. The attitude is so fine that all the effort that is put in to create a garden is lost. Now the garden is created for people to go and rest and enjoy. But they will take their statistics. They'll take all their computers. They'll take their all their books and tapes and make it for instance useless. In the same way, they keep those incarnations and even the subject. Now see the other side. The sun rises. Sun is not bothered. It is not bothered as to who comes to bask in his glory. What the sun does is to throw the light. The sun wants to make you happy, wants to give you joy and life. That's his job and that's his duty. It is not counting how many heads I am enlightening. It is not counting how many doors I am knocking, how many windows I have to open. It is not for. Now if somebody wants to get the sunshine, it has to come out and open itself and take the sunshine. On the contrary, people would say, I mean, as they say in Bali, that why, if it is the sunshine, in my room there is darkness. If there is a sunshine, my room must be completely enlightened. Not only but in the cell if I go, it should be enlightened. Even if I go inside the cave, it should be enlightened. If I am standing in the center of a tunnel also, it should be enlightened. And even if I cover myself in completely dark, still I will see the light. This is the demand. Now the poor son is doing what he thought. I'll see. This is the position of human beings when they look at anybody who has something in life. That they want, once we have got realization, we should just get everything in a fantasy. Why should we? Actually, that you have got realization itself is a very big goal. Itself is a very big happening in your life which has happened out of place. After all, you should sit down and see, what have I done after all to get realization? You know, people have to go to jungle. They have to stay in forest where there are tigers and all kinds of dangers. And their rules make them go round and round and round and round and never give them realization in quietly. You have to give up your family, lead a very celibate life, and then get the realization. And then also they are not responsible for the charity. You have to go on in this. So forget about these horrible fake ones who are in the city and are just making money and all kinds of things. So I'm not talking about them, but the real person. If you have got the realization, you can get it as a matter of life. This is your best. But you have been chosen by God, definitely, that you have got it. There must be some reason for your choice. But if you are chosen, if a candidate is chosen for a job, he has to be worthy of it. On the contrary, what we demand, like every labor union does that. Once we've got a job, whether we do it or not, it is our right to have more pay. Whether the company is making profit or not, it is our right to have more pay. It is not our duty to work, but it is our right to have it. But it is gain, who is the loser? Because the son is not the loser. It is the one who shuns and runs into a tunnel. He is going shouting, "Oh son, if you are there, then I must get right here. If you are really there, this must happen to me." So the son will say, "All right, my child, go ahead with your offer." So the attitude of human beings has been of this kind. And that is the reason why, so far, incarnations have been failures. Another very big problem is this, which perhaps you don't realize. I'm getting to the beginning of that. You don't realize that another very, very big problem, which means a person as a subject. A person like the sun, and the person who is seeking the sun, who is having an objective attitude going. There's a tremendous difference, because when you are thirsty, you are counting every stone by which you pass. You count every turn you take. You count every tree you visit. You write books about what dangers you have had. And that knowledge of yours is not known to the person who is the subject, because he's standing there on top of it. For example, I don't know, supposing tomorrow, if he answers an ignorant person, that who is the prime minister of Islam. What does it matter? And incarnation, you will not get any mark in your master mind constitution either. Not even a single mark to be there. He may not know who is the governor general, or who is the viceroy, or who is in such and such year, who was born, and in such and such year, who died. All this knowledge is avidya. He is not going to know all this, because this is changeable. All this knowledge that mastermind has, who wrote this book and who wrote that book, this knowledge has no value for the self. Because these are changing every day. Today somebody is a prime minister, tomorrow somebody will be a prime minister, or she will be a prime minister, or he will be a prime minister, or he will be the president. It's all the same. Has no value at all of eternal nature. No value. Just think of it. Just like your clothes, you are changing everything. Even our body, we are changing. So this knowledge, if you go and ask, so when you try to come here and if you ask me, you say, I have no idea as to what it is. But there are some people who can just tell you what is the dimension of this soul. Or they can even tell you, mastermind will tell you from where this has come, who has invented, who has done it and all that. Or maybe somebody else who can find out something from science and say this is this. But through an incarnation or through a subject, this is a vidya of nowhere. Like small children bouncing the pebbles on the shores of water. And then you go and ask the father, now tell me, how many I have got in my hand? A sweet question, O God. But very innocent. And ignorant. Because what is the responsibility for the father that you have 10 or 5 in your hand? Does it matter? So for a subject, the knowledge that is important is the absolute knowledge which never changes, which is eternal nature. The absolute knowledge, for example, you can say that the sun has, that yes, when the sun shines, the waves will soak, and they will transform the heat, and then it will get chlorophyll. The oxygen will give them life. This is the knowledge of it. And he does not go on counting and making a record of how many heads he has touched. But human attitude is such that they will blame the sun for giving them cold. The difference between a human being and a subjective is that human beings think that there are many people in the boat and that they are all responsible for the folly of this one person, while he is not. And the subjective is that he is the only person. Nothing else. Everyone in this world is part and parcel of this being. He's the only one in the world. He doesn't know of another. He doesn't know what is the other. He just knows himself. And he is the one, the only one that exists. The rest are just part and parcel. He doesn't know the difference between I and you. He doesn't blame anyone because anything goes wrong with anyone is no blaming, but it's a part. If some portion dies off, it dies off. Like my nails, if they fall off, they fall. That is of no importance to an incarnation. He doesn't try to show off. He doesn't want to say that this is I, this is I, this is I. No. You make it out yourself. And he doesn't blame you. He will never hate you nor the hurt you. Can we hate our own hands? Can we hate our own eyes? Can we hate our own nose? When everything is your own, the world hatred goes. doesn't impress you by external things. He doesn't. He's not bothered as to how we should talk, how we should stand, what form we should say, to say what thing, because he does not impress you by his outward behavior. But he affects you through his own height, by his own dignity, by his own personality, which is within. It's a very deep understanding. If human beings can touch that, then they will know that God Almighty has done everything under the sun to make you aware of this. He's done everything that can be possible under his might to make you feel the joy that surrounds you. He has created this garden for you to enjoy, and he makes every effort for you to feel. But in this effort, there is only one very strong point that you are free to choose the light or dark. You have been given this freedom. If you want to have light, you can have. But if you don't have it, you cannot blame God for it. You have to blame yourself. There is something missing in you. There is something that you have shunned. There is something that you have avoided. In the same way as today I declare that the new age starts. I do declare. I accept. But when I say that, immediately people think you mean we are going to get a shower of blessings. This new age, after all, you see, we are going to be put into the soul of the kingdom of heaven. And that nothing is going to bother us, and everything is going to be wonderful. Thank God. I do not say that. You have to expose yourself to that beautiful realm. You have to open up yourself to that realm. There are so many ways in some of your life by which you have to open up. You know what are the bases are there, how to please them, how to please the organizers within you, how to organize yourself so that you get the maximum benefit from it. I can only tell you that. I can help you to open that. But if you deny, if you don't want it, nobody is going to beg of you, or neither nobody is going to work with you. It has to work out with your full freedom and full asana. Of course, first the thing of the Mahaprana happens despite that, like the force of the river that is just going there and that time. But the change is your own job. But then what happens if this new age comes? You may say, Mother, what special thing is going to happen? See, we have more expectations than we have. I like a mother is giving you a little chocolate and then a little test on and then chocolate and then test on. It's between the two, the thing is working out. So what do you expect to do? Frustrating for the girls. They would like to know, Mother, what is the special thing they are going to get? With the working of the new age. No cruelty will be tolerated. No despotism will be tolerated. No harshness will be tolerated. Nobody can take away the sanctity of a girl who is gay. Not the prostitute. Nobody can force anyone to overpower any religion or any Christian man. Especially as a Christian. Unless he himself falls into the grave. That's a different one. Nobody is going to be overpowered by any satanic force unless and until you want. But you find out in yourself, are you not playing into the hands of the satanic force yourself or not? Are you not listening to them and even judging everything that is around you? If you are, then don't blame. But if you are not, let that all go. All those verses are there, they are all going to come. But you have to be absolutely that. Everyone who is very arrogant will always say, I am a very humble man. And to please him, praise him, even the people, they have seen that. Please excuse me, but I will tell you about bureaucracy. When they want to please another bureaucrat, they say, sir, I haven't met another humble man like you. And the sir is absolutely happy. It's a common thing that people try to go and say, if you are really humble in your heart, then nobody can overpower you. That is what is success. But we have to know how many of us are there. We can try and say, oh Lord, we have suffered so much. We are very ignorant sometimes. And we think, oh, how I have suffered in my life. I mean, we don't try to not say so much as people say. And I find a very big bugging of people inside them, just settle down. And here is Rama Kavira. I see that. Well, how much we offer each other, how much we give each other, how much we make the things secure in life. Do we really love each other? If you really do, if you ate, no one will disappear. But sincerity must not be your judgment, but the judgment of God. Like the saints have really suffered in the past. But how many are saints? Krishna says, Paritrana and Sadhana. Ninasha is the Krishna. Sambhavani. In this world I come again and again. To destroy evil people and to protect the sovereign society and to establish the dharma for sadhanasthaya, dharma for sadhanasthaya, sambhavani yogyena samadhi mandita. Now we have to find out how many are the real things. Everything has got some sort of a black spiritual. Thanks to these horrible things also, they have installed and set it up on the universe. Thanks to the atmosphere and the environment around, there are some more attacks. And thanks to your own understanding and your own, I would say, ignorance about things, that they are still nicely having a very good job in life. Activate first. They cannot activate without your help, without your complete support. For those who want that this new age should help us, this new age should give us something special, Whatever I have promised and I have said today, that all those who are released, all the blessed people who are described in the Bible will receive their blessings. And nobody can overpower you, but you should judge yourself or you guys. To expect, even from realization, people expect that the whole heaven should fall into their head and that all the blessings of the God should come into them. After all, what has been done? Judge it yourself. I see in the West, I find self-destroying instruments have been used socially and civilly. Absolutely, I've tried to see that in the future. Ultimately, still you go to the society. Either you have done it or somebody has done it. One of them. And it is very difficult first to separate yourself from your sanity, whether it is ego or super ego, under which you are. And to expect everything, you have to know that there is a complete protection from all the angels above you, a complete looking after the yogakshema of Mahavir, and a complete blessing on you. That physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, and also financially. It is very important. You will be blessed because all these chakras are denied. But if you have no proper cloth to receive it, a torn cloth, what's the use of donating anything without falling down? So today, whatever was possible has been done for you to be the human being, and also today is the day when the complete doors of the heavens have opened out to you. At this time, you have to resolve that I will try or I will be. That power is each other. And not waste my energy something that is so superficial, super pure, and actually using benefiting every moment. This resolve we are to make. Only with this resolve we will see the flow of the vibration. And this is what I would like you to believe. Those who have got realization, it's not difficult. Those who have got it to be, it's rather strong than it's very fancy. It's a fact. All over the world, all over the universe, the forces are going down and down and down. They are trying to work out everything else, but only your opening, your exposure to them is. And that exposure is like an exposure of a little rock into the ocean. Just like a little rock into the ocean. Now, if the rock says, oh, that means I have to surrender myself. These are all human side of things. Do I surrender my ego or my super ego? You surrender both. What you should not surrender is your spirit, if you have. Which one is the one that will teach you how to live? Neither your ego nor your spirit. You understand that you are a part, a big part in the drama of life. That you are going to play a very big role in the drama of God Almighty. But it is necessary that you have to be prepared to play that role. Now the last thing I want to tell you is today, it is our theme and our theme, that everybody is under the impression that heaven is going to open and that the incarnation is going to come on a horse and is all going to take us to heaven to see it. It's a fact. It will happen. It has happened. But when? When it will happen? Then he is just coming here to sort out. Just to sort out all the useless ones and take all the rest. Then when I reach my Janani, little I'm like, oh, because I'm useless. So that's what he told me. He is just coming for the last blessing. There won't be any chance for realization, no chance for emancipation, no chance for improvement, nothing. He will just come and throw away the hopeless people and take to him the ones who have improved themselves, who are there. So don't expect him just come. We are not yet ready. Still we have very few Sahajyogis and out of them also most of them are. So let us postpone his coming for the time being and put attention to our emancipation to a point where when he comes, he takes us in his hold. That was said because to frighten you, that you hurry up against the fire. But he hurried up into his wrong direction, absolutely. And he took two jumps to hell. And yeah, it's a big problem how to raise you from that. You don't know, it's a big problem. Though I smile and laugh inside me, I reach for trying to find people invaded in the mud of history. I'm in the mud of satanic force, the whole mire. With this new age, a new body has come. And if you want to go to that, if you want to be there, it will be expedited, such meeting with that love. And we are going to be helped much more. Because the surrounding you is here, you will see the awareness of people. People will change their attitude and their. And they take eternal values, the value structure in man's teaching, his priorities will change, the value structure of the society will change. These things can happen. And you will be benefited by it. Actually, the whole value structure of human beings is so badly damaged and so perverse that to put it right, has been a very big problem. Especially the darkness is much more problem. In the dark is better. But when the sun is on top of your head, it can be even better and better and better. So we have on this day grateful. I'm sorry, I have to tell you these things to help you. Because on Saturday I suggest to you too. And just love you and wish you a new second. But when the children are suffering, when they are weak, when they are sick, the mother has to tell them what they should eat, what they should not. You cannot give them things when they are not right. You have to give them insipid, horrid things if you would not be patient. You feel like starving yourself and fasting yourself when you feel that you can't give them what you want to do. Because they are sick, their stomachs are sick, their minds are up. So I request you, all of you, to work everything that is possible to put yourself in proper place. So that the value structure in dharma within you is settled down properly. And that you receive the fruit of your handling and your teaching, because you have been patient for the truth and teaching, and you have made lots of mistakes in your teaching. Doesn't matter. Everything is fine. And all the time, and whatever help you want, we are going to work with. I'm so thankful to you for doing all this. But when I see Kalki here, I must tell you, this is the price to pay. This I love him very much, no doubt. He's my dearest son, and everything is there. But he is going to come with 11 brothers. He is going to reduce everybody into ashes and pour it into the hell. So I just now do not want it to come. It is not the time for it. No, no. My children are still very sick. Some of them are very unhappy. Some of them have been tortured, have been reduced to nothing. Let me help them. Get them there. And then when they are all right, then he is welcome to come. Then he is all right. Before that, no. And he is a very obedient child. He is the most obedient child. And he is. And he loves me very much. He is not going to take it, but he has to pay those who have tried to kill all that is evil.
Pardon me for the first time. You, thank you. All others are old people. All right. Out of you, those who do not see the vibration. Did you come before? Did you? You felt the vibration in the hand? Did you? No, I'm asking you. I'm asking you. Yes, did you?
Yes.
You felt them nicely, didn't you? Yeah. What about you? Are you feeling now? Full in the hand? Good. Now, just put your hands to three languages, all of them. Hello? Please. Are you feeling good? Huh? Yes. What are you feeling? Walk. It will go away. That's all. That's my place. Yes, you have little faith in me. That's something. Little, not much. All right? You don't think I'm a crook, do you? It's all right. All of them. What is it? Oh, it's calling me. It will call. What about you? Nothing. Please? Yeah. Have you been to some guru? No one. Are you keeping all right, health-wise? Are you feeling it? Nothing? Put your feet on the ground like that. Just look towards me if you could. So put it off now.
Some idea that there is God. And also we know that He is reflected in us, in our heart, as spirit, as atma, as self. Now, when we know about the three channels that are working in us, of Mahakali, Mahalakshmi and Mahasaraswati, the three powers of Hinda, Pimala and Sushumna, which create the subconscious, the conscious and the conscious mind. Are working in our consciousness. That means we are conscious of them. We are conscious of our
left and right, that is Ila and Pinna, sympathetic nervous system. You are not conscious of the parasympathetic. That means that we can increase the rate of our heart, we can increase the rate of our breathing, but we cannot decrease. The decrease, or what you call the lowering down of the rate, is done by parasympathetic. So the parasympathetic is active, but we are not conscious of it in the sense that we have no control over it. The spirit that is God, which is reflected in us, resides in the heart. The manifestation of spirit in our heart controls the parasympathetic. But this spirit is the reflection of God Almighty in our heart, as if in a mirror. And divine love, which is the light of God, is reflected in us through the reflection of the spirit as the unconscious mind. So within us there is an area about which we are not conscious. That is why it is called as unconscious. That area lies so far away from our conscious mind that we cannot control it. We are not conscious of it. But it acts through parasympathetic acting. How it acts, I will give you a simile. Supposing there is a power work somewhere, and it is acting through this light over here. You don't see the power work, or the factory, or wherever the power is seen. But what you see in the manifestation here, and you see the light. But supposing you do not see the light, nor the lamp, nor the fact, but you are affected by it. That is the situation of a human being. A normal human being who is not a realized soul is not aware of that factory which is God, or the light which has gone, is not aware of the lamp that he has got in his heart, and is also not aware of the light that the lamp is in. But it is that. So the unconscious mind is nothing else but the projection of God's will through the light of divine love. I've given this simile again and again, which is very good and apt, that these two powers that are within us, one on the left, another on the right hand side, are there and we are conscious of them and we use them. Out of them, the right, we use it in absolute awareness. Left one, we know, is used as subconscious mind, and sometimes
If you take drugs or if you do something like that, then you go to your subconscious also. So you can become aware of the subconscious area also. So you become, you are aware of the right hand side already, and you are aware of the subconscious sometimes when you try to get aware of it. So these two powers that are within us are all the time vibrating in a wave. And the points at which they meet, they create the thought. Or you can say the center. Center is created, a deity is created. But there is no light for us to see or to feel or to be conscious of the deities. Deities are past asleep. When the Kundalini rises, now Kundalini is the subconscious. You'll be surprised that Kundalini is the Mahakali power. She is absolutely pure in the purest form. Because she is not used. You can say part of it is used in us, our subconscious. Sort of we have kept some water separately, which we have not used so far. So first of all we use the subconscious water and the preconscious water. And we dirty. We exhaust it. Then this stored up power rises and does the last cleansing. But when she rises, she creates a third current. Still that third current, when she's rising, doesn't have the light. But when it reaches the Sahasrara and pierces it, then it becomes one with the universal consciousness. Because what is God is the one who controls the universal consciousness. He is the controller of the universal consciousness. He emits the light. And when this Kundalini rises, it gets that flame on it. So now all the deities get awakened. Now you may say that it is in the heart, Mother, you are saying it is here. It is a confusion, people say. But actually it is all pervading. Say, God is a nucleus, you can say, or a factory. It has the light all over and is reflected in the heart. So when your Kundalini, a particular individual Kundalini, touches that, then this light takes place. Then the heart, in the heart the spirit is ignited. Or sort of it emits it, it manifests, it projects. And its projection are these vibrations. So through this you know the will of God. Through this you have a dialogue with God and you understand what He wants. And what does He want you to know? There are three qualities of God which you can feel through this. One, what is the truth? You ask any question. If you are asking for something, and if it is in yes, then you get too many vibrations. If it is in no, vibrations will low down. That's how you can verify
what is right, what is wrong, what is the truth, what is not the truth. Now you can know. Nobody has to tell you. You don't need any clergyman or anybody to certify. It is there through your vibrations. You can feel it. Is this the truth or not? Is it the correct place you have come to or to the wrong place? But also the various combinations and permutations of these, you see, it is true, but still there's a little point which is wrong in you. For example, if you say that Christ was resurrected in person, yes, that's true. You get more vibration. But if you see now, that if you say, is it Mataji, the mother of Christ, if you do not accept it, you will not get it on this earth. It's easy for you. That is how now, for you to understand what is the truth. Now, once you understand the truth, and if you are identified with it, which is a very difficult thing for a mind, Western mind, I find, immediately what you get, the second quality of what is joy. The second quality of the unconscious is joy. You should hear some of the letters that people write to me, those who have identified. For Indians, it's very easy to recognize me. You see, because they do not see only as Christ's mother, but they know me throughout, you see. So immediately they know the one who raises the kundalini, the one, you see, when they fall at my feet, then the kundalini rises, you see. Finished. That's the sign. No problem. For them, no problem. So they accept it very fast. But in these ego-oriented society, it's very difficult. So they do not accept. The problems are there. But once if you start identifying with that truth and understanding, just think that you are sitting before me and who am I? Just think of that. Who am I sitting down before you say, I am that? Then see the joy, see the waves of joy which just tickle your lips. But this truth is not easily identified. If it is identified, then you get the second thing, known as joy. Now the third quality of what is attention. Means that he is attention. Can you understand that? In English it's very difficult, but what I'm saying is attention. Means wherever he is attention. Now, how would you explain it? But, you see, for example, I'm sitting down here. I'm not paying any attention to him, but I'm attention. In the sense it flows. Like the water, you see, you put it somewhere. Wherever there is a lower area, it will flow to that. The water doesn't move. Its nature is such that it flows to that in the same way. I'm not paying consciously any attention, but my nature is attention. If you pray to me, it will happen. But you should be able to receive my attention in the sense that my attention should penetrate into your false world. If you are false, it will not act, because it understands. The attention understands everything that you are. It's like a computer, even faster than that. Supposing my hand is here, and you prick me with a pin, immediately my hand will go away like that, immediately. Even though before you have pricked me, my hand will, if I see. If my attention is there, my hand will immediately, all the muscles relax and it will take away the hand from there. In the same way, we can say even much quicker than that is the attention of God. And it starts acting through you.
Anybody you want to think of, you just think of only that. It's breath. It's breath. You can attend to your relations, you can think about your mother, you can think about your father, you can attend of that. Then you rise like this. When you grow higher and higher and higher, then the whole personality becomes nothing but attention. It's the same thing. It's the same thing expressed in three ways. It's the same thing. But when your attention is everywhere, you are joy. Because of attention you receive the joy. Because you are truth. That's why you are joy. Because nothing but truth can give you joy. Self can never give you joy. For the timing will be happy or unhappy. But joy is a thing, it never changes its quality. It's not a dual thing, it's one thing. Many people say like this, I'm very happy. That's not the truth. It is joy, which cannot be described. Just think, supposing I am that. Because for you still I am a supposing. Just think of that. If so, how is that to change in yourself? Now, it's acting in you and it's excited in you. It's the ocean of truth, joy and attention. And you get that. The way you are joyous, I am also joyous too. The way you are standing on truth, I am also standing on the truth. The way you are paying attention, I am also paying attention. You just by talking, you take somebody's name. Immediately you get the indication from the hand. Without attention, it is not coming there. But the attention, you are not conscious of it, it just works. Because God is within you acting, who is attention himself. He pays attention to everything. You are talking about somebody just by the way you are talking, suddenly, oh, I thought it, why? Oh, that has got disturbed. Immediately God indicates because he's so attentive. These are the three qualities of God which are manifested. And that is the nature of the unconscious belief. Now it is for us to rise, first of all, to know the truth. Now rationally you know. Rationally you know that there's something about Mataji, definitely there is. But emotionally you cannot integrate. Some people know me emotionally, but they rationally they cannot integrate. Try to integrate both. Start thinking by your heart and loving by your brain. Then it happens. Tell your brain to think of all the ways of loving. How do you express your love to someone in words? Start off. Just say few words. Just now he said something. Hail Mary face. From here and here and here, you see, started going. Only that hail itself was. See now, only this word. How much wonder. It's so simple. nothing so complicated as the psychologist makes. Absolutely, it is very simple. But when the Kundalini rises, she does the simple job. She is kept there for that. She knows her job. She is aware. She knows me very well. As soon as she sees me, she rises. Of course, she is kept there only for this day when you have to meet her. She works it out. And she is wondering, what's wrong with this children? Why don't they understand? This is the nature of the unconscious. About which we say we are not conscious, that's why it's unconscious, but not anymore with you people. You are conscious of it. You are conscious of it. Not only that, but you know all these things. What is this? What are these fingers? But think from the God's point of view. If I were from human point of view, you only think. But think from his point of view. He wants to evolve you people to a higher state. You must realize with all your intelligence that still you have not reached that point from where you can say it is completed now. You have not met that power which is described, which says, let it be and it happens. So there is something, transition is still there. You have to achieve that point. That is true. Alright. That means you are still unconscious of some things which you have not known so far. You have to evolve. Now, what is the God's position? Supposing he has been evolving you throughout. Now, at this stage when he has given you all the freedom, and like madcap you are yet trying to do something to you. For example, a mother, she allows her child to be free and the child is going to put the fingers in the socket. She just has to come and tell, no, don't do that. That will give you birth. She has to birth. God has to tell you. And how is he going to tell you? He has to have a mouth. He has to learn English. He has to talk to you. He has to have hands like you. Then, otherwise, how is he going to tell? Human mind is so funny that they think that if you are helped monetarily, oh, God is with me. Is he your servant? That he is in your pocket. Oh, God was very kind to me. If I went there, he was very kind to me and he helped me. But how do you say it was God who has helped you or what has helped you? How do you know? Everybody thinks that God is their servant standing at the door. Oh, God, do they say, give job to me, give job to another person. You, God, you look after me, give me food, everything. Oh, God. Let us win the war against this and do this and protect and all sorts of things are done under the name of God. But whether the gentleman is there or not is not known. So the gentleman has to take a face on the mouth to talk to you. To tell you about these subtle things. They are subtle but not difficult. They are simple. But when he takes the body, it's a big dilemma for him. He takes the body, people say, how can he read? First of all, they do not believe in themselves that they can face, that he can come, first of all. They themselves are suffering from inferiority complex. And they cannot think, how can he be a human being just like us? But if he is clever enough, he can make a drama out of it. He can copy you better than you can copy yours. God. That is what human beings do not understand. That he can do everything, all types of things, and whatever you are doing also, is done in his life. But depends on his attention, you see. Just now his attention is on one thing. Throughout in the world he wants Kundalini awakening, Sahaja Yoga to be established. That's what his thing is. First of all, let people feel the vibrations, otherwise what are, am I going to talk to them and what are you going to do with them? So this is the only attention working now. There is no miracle, nothing. You have your realization. No resurrections, no crucifixions, nothing anymore. You just have all of you your vibrations. Correct them. That's how you keep the light ready. And that's how you enlighten the one. Now you may say, his light, why should we enlighten our part? His life for himself. You see, a potter who makes pots and small little lights also, lamps. He makes lamps. He is like himself, but he makes lamps, small lamps. Then he fills it with oil. Then he puts a wick of Kundalini. Then he lights it. When such light fills his heart with reflected joy, he wants to see his reflection